Karnak's giant obelisks are one of the greatest marvels of the ancient world. These massive single pieces of rock have puzzled archaeologists for years. That's because they're carved from one of the hardest rocks on Earth, granite.
Obelisk is a big mystery in ancient Egypt, not for the reason why they just make the obelisk, but the reason for how to cut it.
How did the ancient Egyptians work this toughest of materials with only primitive tools? Although only two still stand today, at its prime, Karnak boasted 13 colossal obelisks. Six dominated the center of the temple at the festival hall. The tallest towered 100 feet high. And all were made from super tough granite to stop them from snapping. The tips were painted with glimmering gold to reflect the sun's rays. Engravings boast they were carved in just 7 months. But how? Adel Kalani has spent his career unearthing the secrets of Egyptian stonemasons. He's convinced that the metal chisels used to build limestone pyramids and sandstone temples would have had little effect on the tough granite used to build the obelisks. Today, he examines a half-extracted obelisk, most likely abandoned by the Egyptians when the massive blocks split.
Fortunately for us, it is not finished because it gives us a lot of clues how the Egyptians cut obelisk from hard stone like granite.
Adel first examines the surface of the stone for telltale marks, but the dents he finds are hard to interpret. Next, he looks in the dirt under the stone and uncovers something surprising.
We did find ash and charcoal. This is important for us. That's a proof that fire sitting operation are the main techniques for splitting hard stones.
The surprise discovery of charcoal suggests that fire may have played some part in the extraction of the giant blocks. To test the theory, Adel lights a series of fires on top of a nearby outcrop. He wants to see if heating and then quenching the hard rock makes it easier to work.
We need to try and to test the fire setting operation and how it could help for making the work extremely fast.
The team keeps a close eye on the temperature while checking for any signs of weakness.
We can hear a cracking sound, which is really quite strong. And that's make the workmen a bit scared that stone actually fallen down while they are on the top of this stone. So that's actually promising that there are some movement, but we have to wait until the fire calm down.
The team quenches the fire with water.
Wow. But if you come close to see, the stone actually just completely cracking. This is the result of cooling the fire by water, and this is, looks like destroyed the whole surface.
To test if the fire has made the hard rock easier to work, Adel instructs one team to pound the heated rock. For comparison, he gets another to pound on the untreated surface. Both hammer for 9 minutes. Then Adel examines the results.
If you need to comment the distance of the work in around 9 minutes, it's about 5 centimeters, and here it's a few millimeters. It's really big difference.
The heat-treated hole is nearly 2 inches deep, seemingly 10 times quicker to work through than the untreated rock. A stunning result. It's early days, but Adel believes fire was the key to building cars.